Well, we are well known for our relaxed attitude to life, but Aussies are also prolific inventors. In fact, we well and truly punch above our weight, creating plenty of things that have changed the world. Science journalist Wendy Zukerman has come up with her list of some of the best of them. And it's a real surprise package, isn't it, Wendy?
Yes. I thought we'd start with perhaps the most tenuous link. Google Maps was developed mostly in Australia by two Danish brothers, Lars and Jens Rasmussen.
Oh, okay, yes.
That's right. No, really, the only reason they found themselves in Australia was because one had a Cuban girlfriend, who's now his wife, couldn't get a visa into America, so found their way into Australia.
And we'll take them.
Came here and couldn't find their way around because the streets are so confusing, so they had to invent Google Maps.
Exactly.
I love it. Great idea.
Remarkably, they had $16 in their pockets when they were pitching this to all these entrepreneurs. No one liked the idea. Finally, they met up with Larry Page and he said, I'll take it.
Wow.
They're doing very well for themselves.
What about Wi-Fi?
Wi-Fi is another sort of the little guy that came up and battled them all story. John O'Sullivan from CSIRO and his team developed the Wi-Fi, then had to battle all of the big guns for it in a massive court case that ended in 2012 with a really large settlement. So we can take the Wi-Fi as our own.
And the CSIRO still gets royalties from it, doesn't it? But it only gets, I think it's only got about 400 million or something, which you would think for something that everyone in the world now uses.
Yeah, 3 billion devices around the world are said to use Wi-Fi and they had to make a settlement of around $400 million. Wow. So, I mean, and then I was reading some blogs and people are still saying, oh, you never proved that Wi-Fi was Australian because you made a court settlement. It wasn't a judgment. We'll take it as our own.
I would like to know why the NBN doesn't know about Wi-Fi.
that's another kettle of fish.
Yeah, that's a discussion for another day. You and I could have a really good talk about that.
The bionic ear.
Yes.
As well.
Yes, absolutely.
That's right. Dr. Graham Clark. We thank him for that. It's being used by over 200,000 people around the world. Mm-hmm. Again, this guy was called a clown when he was working on the device. People didn't think it was going to work.
First time.
And look at that.
Amazing.
That's amazing.
It makes me cry when I see those little kids. And the jewel flush dunny.
The jewel flush dunny, that's right. We've got to be proud of ourselves for this. Bruce Thompson. As if we don't have enough choices in the world. It saves millions of litres of water every year. Now we have two options.
So simple as well.
Exactly, but not because they had to design the bowl to be able to use less water to flush down everything. Right. Seems simple.
As they say, if it's brown, flush it down. If it's yellow, let it mellow.
No. Yeah.
Please, we're not in drought at the moment, Joe. We can't have to worry about it at the moment.
Debatable, that one.
I think it's even older, the saving water in the dunny. I know I've spoke about toilet rolls last time, but when we were kids, we used to put a brick in the cistern. Yeah. Remember? So it took up less water.
That's
Archimedes, you put a brick in.
And that was the inspiration for the working out how they could have a jewel flush.
They must have had relatives in the country.
Jane, your childhood sounds like Bear Grylls.
We've also got the feature films.
Yep.
That's right. In 1906, the story of the Kelly Gang is widely thought to be the very first feature film. Remarkably, you can see how violent it is right there. Kids were so excited about it. There were reports of criminal activity. Kids in Ballarat made their own little gangs and held up other kids at gunpoint after watching
this
film.
No, so why are we worrying about video games? We've been doing it forever.
Exactly. It was wildly popular. We'll take feature films as our own.
It's good to see kids getting outdoors and making their own
Exactly. Displayed. Now, someone's given me a spork here. That's clearly a different utensil.
Yeah. That is not a splayed.
That's not a splayed.
What's a splayed?
It needs a knife. On the side. It really needs to unite.
Don't you cut your mouth then?
I'm really disappointed because I should have actually been thinking about what we were going to. I actually have splayed at home.
Like
I could have
ones?
Brought one in.
It's got to have a little bit of a blade.
I can't believe you've never seen those.
On the side.
So it's a combination. It's a fork, a knife, a spoon, all in one.
It's everything. 1943.
We have family splayeds too. We have the family set. We share them.
And they were invented because, you know, the Aussie Barbie sitting there trying to eat with a plate on your lap, you could actually only needed to have one instrument because you could actually cut and then eat
and
without having to...
And the other hand.
Well, at least balance it all without having to do all this and make sure it didn't fall off your lap. That's my
invention.
Really? Sure.
The notepad as well. This is an Australian invention.
Wow.
1902. It took a Tasmanian stationer.
Wow.
To put a little bit of glue and some cardboard and bam. So remarkably...
It's so simple.
Isn't it? Humans were using paper.
So what I've done, right, is I've got some paper and I've got some glue and then I stuck them together.
And just finally, the goon bag.
The goon bag.
That's not surprising at all.
But of course.
No, that's not
That's the most obvious invention that anyone in Australia could
that's
come up
right.
with.
That's right. 1965, the man who invented the goon bag, when he brought it home to his son was like, you are crazy, as if anyone is going to buy wine shoved in a box with a plastic bag inside. Oh, boy, was he wrong.
Yeah. Oh, boy. Wait, can I just ask, I know I'm ignorant, where does the word goon come from?
Well, we were just
My explanation, my understanding is that when I was younger, you didn't actually have these, because I keep on telling you I'm so old, we had flagons.
Flagons.
And we used to call flagons goons. Mm, right. So I'm assuming that we just translated the goon from the bottle goon into the paper.
Because it was like a gallon or something goon.
But it was a goon. It was always... You call it wine goon. That's what you used to drink goon out
it's
of the goon.
It's been enlightening, Wendy. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you very much. The inflatable escape slide too, which is very cool. It's also
that's a change the face of airline safety.
And the black box as well.
The black box.
Yep,
we have to take a real quick break.